You're not here for the cranial nerve. Great, you're here for the forehead medical. Okay, great. So that means I've got the right patient. So lovely to meet you. My name is Sean. Okay, I'm your doctor for today. So we're going to be doing the forehead or face medical exam, testing a range of different things, including the, you know, your sight, your smell. We're going to be looking inside your mouth, even up your nose, believe it or not. Alright, but it's not going to be any, you know, none of it is painful or anything like that. Okay, so just get yourself nice and relaxed, take a nice deep breath in and out. Okay, wonderful. So, anywhere between 20 to 25 minutes or so. Alright, and as we said, we're going to be testing a range of different things, okay? So I'm just going to take a few notes here, that's okay, and then we'll begin. I'll talk you through the whole process, okay? So there's nothing to worry about. Okay, so to begin, if I could just take your wrist, okay? So just leave your hand by your side, nice and relaxed. I'm just going to take your pulse. Just going to be timing it here with my stopwatch. There we go. So just breathe normally for me. Okay, don't try to slow down your breathing. A lot of my patients do tend to almost show off how slow they can breathe, but no, we'd rather have you breathing normally. Okay, so in through the nose, out through the mouth. Okay, that's great. Okay, that's perfect. Okay, so I'm just going to be referring to my notes and making some new notes throughout the assessment. Okay, but everything is good, so that's wonderful. Okay, so if you don't mind, I'm just going to be looking around your face and feeling either side of your face. Basically, I'm looking for symmetry. Okay, so we're making sure that the muscles are sort of almost holding up parts of our face on the left and right sides in equal measure. Okay, so I'm just looking to make sure that the face hasn't fallen on one side. Okay, everything looks fine, just comparing both sides. Obviously, our faces are not entirely symmetrical, but I'm just looking for some obvious discrepancies, and I'll be pleased to say that your face is fine. Okay, I'm just going to be touching around your face if you don't mind, okay? Thank you. Okay, so again, just looking and feeling at the muscle, making sure they feel more or less the same on both sides, and again, just looking for any major discrepancies from one side of the face to the other. Come around to the side here. So just keep looking forward and stay nice and relaxed for me. That's wonderful, you're doing very well. So it's good. Again, I'm just taking a look on the other side. Okay, making sure I don't step on your foot. Okay, everything seems fine on this side. Alright, so I'm going to be touching your face once more, starting with underneath the eyes. I don't expect you to be in any pain or discomfort, however, if you do feel anything that's causing you any pain or discomfort, please do let me know, alright? But you're doing well so far, so well done. Okay, if you could just take a gulp in for me. Okay, and once more, if you can swallow. Okay, any pain when I press there? Alright, hold on. So again, I'm going to make a few notes here, okay? Just writing down the findings, just to document what it is we've been doing today, and obviously the results as well. It's, so far, everything is looking normal, Okay, so you'd be pleased to know. Okay, that's great. So I will want to actually, oh, this is a lot easier for me. If you could perform a range of different faces for me, okay? So I will ask you to perform certain faces, and I do assure you this is serious. I'm not joking when I ask you to do these, okay? It just enables me to look at both sides of your face, again, just to observe symmetry while the actions are performed, okay? Alright, so do prepare yourself. Okay. So first of all, and I want you to hold these poses to the best of your ability for at least 3 seconds, okay? Now, could you please raise your eyebrows and keep them there? Okay, keep them there for me. That's great, and relax. Alright, if you could puff out your cheeks for me. And keep them there. Keep them puffed out. Okay, and relax for me. Alright, if you can give me a big TV smile, please. So keep it there for me. Okay, well done, and relax. If you could frown your eyebrows for me. Okay, looking good. That's fine. Relax. Alright. So now I want you, just in a moment, not quite yet, I want you to close your eyes and I'll be attempting to open them with my fingers. I want you to resist, okay? So what I'm going to be doing is trying to open your closed eyes and you will be trying your best to keep them closed. Okay, does that make sense? Alright, so close your eyes for me. That's fine, I'm going to be trying to open your eyes. And resist. And that's fine, relax, open your eyes. We can do it one more time, okay? So you can close your eyes for me. That's fantastic. And I'm going to try and open them, so resist. And there we go, well done. Okay, no problems there. That's absolutely fantastic. Alright, so I'm going to be feeling around your jaw if you don't mind. Okay, so just feeling around the jaw. Alright, in a moment I'll be asking you to open and close your mouth a few times, okay? Okay, if you can open your mouth for me. Just not too wide that it's uncomfortable. That's fine. Again, let me know if there's any pain or discomfort whatsoever when I'm performing this task. Okay, if you can shut your mouth for me. Okay, and open please. And close. Okay, and open. And finally close for me. Alright, that's brilliant, thank you. So we're testing your sense of sensations or touch across various points on each side of your face. Okay, we're going to be doing that with 2 different implements. We have the sharp implement, okay, which is just a pair of tweezers. Alright, they're not sharp particularly, but it will give you a sharp sensation. Okay, so it won't be breaking the skin. It'll be nice and gentle, I assure you. We have a soft implement as well. Okay, so this is a Q-tip or a cotton bud if you prefer, and this will represent the soft implement. Okay. So we have the sharp and the soft. Okay. So I'm going to be just very gently brushing this across the strategic points on your face on both sides, and I want you to tell me, does it feel sharp? Okay, so if it feels sharp, just say yes. If it doesn't, say no. Okay, all right, there we go. not too scary, I hope. Okay, that's good. So, same again with these soft. Very well. Swab or the cotton bud or Q-tip if you prefer. Now, once again, I'm going to be touching your face with this. I just want you to give me a yes when you can feel it. Okay, so similar to before, only this time I want you to say yes when you can feel me brush this across your face. Okay, here we go. So we're moving on to your ears, okay? So I'm just going to be feeling around the ears, nice and gentle, and after which we'll take a look using the otoscope. Okay. Alright. So looking forward for me. Just have a little look at the ear. Okay, just bending the ear back a bit. Squeezing the lobe, just making sure. Any pain at all. Okay, any pain at all when I was touching the other ear. Okay, so I'm just going to look in both ears with this otoscope. Okay, it looks scary, but believe you me, there's no pain or discomfort involved whatsoever. Okay, so again, if you can just look forward for me, that's great. Sure, we'll change the nozzle here. Now. Okay, nice and gentle. There we go. So that does look fine. Again on the other side, okay. There we go then. Set in the scope now, nice and gently. Okay, so similar story here. And we have a healthy amount of earwax. Not too much. We have an ear canal free of inflammation. Here, just to mention that the ear canals looked healthy, the eardrum was fine, and there was nothing in there that would cause me any concern or anything that requires any sort of further investigation. Okay, so that's all very good. Alright, so a quick hearing test, if you don't mind. I'm going to be covering over one of your ears, rustling fingers in the other. I want you to tell me if you can hear it. Okay, so nice and simple. Okay, so I'm coming over your right ear. Okay, could you hear that? Okay. Alright, I'm going to do the opposite now, so covering your left. Same again. Covering the right. Okay, could you hear that? Okay. Alright, and covering the left once more. Oh, could you hear that? Okay. Alright. I must admit, the sound my gloves were making on your right side, that was a lot lower than the sound on the left. Okay, so I thought I'd let you know, just in case you was hearing a lot less sound in the right. That was actually my fault. But the fact that you could hear them on both sides is fine. So it's almost like a sort of impromptu test within the hearing test. Alright, that's fine. So we're busting out the musical instruments here. Okay, this is a tuning fork. And now we're going to be testing just if you can hear the tuning fork more or less equal on both sides, okay? So first of all, I'm going to be hitting the tuning fork here. Alright, and then afterwards I'm going to be placing it on your forehead and then give it another hit. Okay. So all I need you to tell me is, can you hear the tuning fork roughly the same through both ears, or does it sound very loud on one side and very quiet on the other? Alright. Did it sound more or less the same on your right and your left sides? Okay, so as before, I'm going to be, as I said before rather, placing it on your forehead, and I'm going to do the same again, okay? Okay, give that another whack. I'm going to do it one more time because it is a little bit on the low side. I do apologise. There we go. Okay, did it sound more or less the same through your left and through your right ear, or was one side loud and the other quiet? so I'm sure you've seen this before. This is what we refer to as a Snellen chart. Okay, so using both eyes, I want you to read off this line where I point to the letter. Do give me your answer. If you're not quite sure what it is, your best guess is more than acceptable. Okay, so here we go. If you could read this off with both eyes open. You close your left eye, whichever means possible, whichever is more comfortable for you. Okay, read this off for me. Make sure you're not cheating. Okay. And if you could cover your right eye for me and read this line here for me, please. Okay. Fantastic, well done. Alright, so we're over halfway, well over halfway in fact. So you're doing very well. So let me ask you now to follow the tips of my fingers, okay? So keeping your head perfectly still for me. I only want you to move your eyes, okay? So track the tips of my fingers. There we go, keeping your head still. Well done, keep tracking tips on the fingers. That's fantastic, keep tracking the tips. Alright, there we go, and relax. Okay, make a note here. Testing your field of vision, alright? So now this time I want you to keep your head still as before, only this time I want you to look at my nose. I'll be bringing in my fingers twitching like that. I want you to tell me when you can see both fingers twitching in your field of vision without actually moving your head, okay? So look at my nose, tell me when you can see the fingers. Okay, good, we'll do it again. Yeah, that's great, once more. Look at my nose. Okay, well done. So that noise in the background is actually one of our big generators. Unfortunately, there's nothing I can do about that, but some of my patients do actually find that sort of white noise very relaxing, okay? So, I'm hoping you're one of them. Checking your pupils now, they're very, very dim light, okay, so you don't need to look anywhere to avoid the light, it should be perfectly fine for you, okay. I'm just going to be checking the pupils, so looking anywhere you want, it's absolutely fine, okay, it's great, okay. Yeah, very dim light, just for this purpose. We don't like blinding our patients after all. Okay, everything seems fine there. Quick note here. Alright, we're going to do another quick vision test here. Okay, so we're going to be concentrating on your focal length, so your ability to focus at different lengths. Okay, so I'm going to be holding my finger out here. I want you to look at my finger on the very tip. There we go, keep looking at the fingers, I check both of your eyes. That's great, and now I want you to focus, not on my finger but now, on the spots behind me on the back wall. Anywhere you like, just keep focusing on that spot behind me. Okay, that's great. And now if you can focus back onto my fingertip again. Okay, all done. Alright, relax for a moment, we'll do the same again. And once again focus on the tip of my finger. That's wonderful. Keep looking at the tip of the finger as I look at both of your eyes. Okay, once again pick a spot behind me and stare at that for me, please. Okay, switch back to the finger. a spot anywhere you like behind me. Okay, and back to the finger again, please. I say marvellous, I'm relaxing. Okay, we're doing very well. It's great, no problems observed. Focus in different lengths, so I'm very happy with that. Alright, I will now be taking a look almost deep into your eye, if you like, using my ophthalmoscope. Okay, fancy name for my little device here. Now, in order to do this, I will be turning off a couple of the lights in here, okay? And I'll tell you when I'm going to be placing the ophthalmoscope close to your eye, because it will be bright, okay? I will warn you. There we go. Okay, I'm just going to turn off a couple of lights. Just bear with me for a second. Alright, so it's nice and cozy in here now. Okay, I'm going to be just checking the right setting here. There we are. Okay, so first of all, I'm going to be shining the lights in your left eye. Okay, I'm going to be shining the light for approximately 2 to 3 seconds. Okay, so I'm going to shine the light into your left eye in 3, 2, 1, now. There we go, and that's that one done. Okay, I know it's very bright, but it has to be done. We do go as quick as we possibly can. So I'm going to do exactly the same on your right eye. Okay, so shine the bright light in your right eye in 3, 2, 1, now. Okay, and there we go, we're done. Thank you very much. Here we are, coming towards the end of the examination, and so far you've performed better than average with every single test. Okay, so you're doing very, very well indeed, so you should be proud of yourself. Alright, so I'm going to be checking your sinuses now, if you don't mind. This means I'm going to be just going to be feeling around the nose area. Okay, if there's any pain or discomfort, please do let me know. Alright, here we go, so looking forward for me. That's great. Get a little bit closer here and do let me know if there's any pain. Okay, so I'm just checking the sinuses. Okay. Okay, is that painful at all? That feels alright, yeah. So, now we're going to be testing your sense of smell. Yeah, we're pretty much doing everything, so we don't want to leave any stone unturned, okay? So we're going to take good care of you. Alright, so these are 3 everyday smells, okay? So smells you'd be expected to smell every day, if you like, or smells that you'd be very, very familiar with, okay? So think of things like oranges, chocolate, that sort of thing. By the way, that wasn't a clue, okay? Alright, so I'm going to be just passing this across your nose a few times. I want you to take a nice deep breath in through the nose and think about what it could be, and don't answer until I've asked you. Alright? Okay, so an everyday smell, here we go. Just place it under the nose, back and forth. Okay, so take a moment to think what that could be. Smell was. Okay, great. He was right. Hang on. Okay. Nice deep breath in for me. That's great. Okay, just process that smell. Okay, what do you think that second smell was? Okay, third and final smell. Okay, once again, nice deep breath in through the nose. Blurting the answer out. And now you know what I'm going to ask you. What do you think that was? Okay. Hold on. Now I'm going to put the otoscope attachment back on. Unfortunately, this is a time where I'm going to be looking up your nose. Okay, so we're using the most narrow nozzle available. And we'll be quick. Okay, so what I need you to do now is just to ever so slightly raise your chin for me. Okay, there we go. Let's take a quick look up one nostril. Okay, that's fine. And up the other one. Okay, that's fine. Not the most comfortable of exams, I do understand, but it is something we have to do, unfortunately. Alright. And to finish the exam, we'll be checking your mouth if you don't mind, okay? So I'm going to be using a brighter light here. There we go. And I want you to open your mouth if you can for me, please. There we go. Just open your mouth nice and wide, but not too wide that you're hurting jaw, because we don't want to cause you any pain, okay? Okay, if you can say it's good. Just checking out the tonsils and the roof of your mouth, looking for any irregularities in the tonsils themselves, any inflammation, anything enlarged. We're looking at the roof of the mouth, making sure they are they have symmetry on both sides, which they appear to have. Okay, one more time for me. That's great. Okay, just relax your jaw just for a moment. Okay, and I will be asking you in a moment, not right now, to open your jaw one more time. And then I want you, if you can, to lift your tongue up into the roof of your mouth. This will enable me to have a look underneath the tongue, okay? Once we've done that, I want you to then put your tongue into your left cheek. Okay, and then into your right cheek as well, just so I can see all around the mouth, alright? Okay, so if you can open your mouth for me, please. And if you can stick your tongue up into the roof of the mouth. There we go, that's fantastic. Hold it there if you can, please, just for a few more seconds. Okay, now if you can put your tongue into your left cheek for me. And if you can put your tongue into the right cheek for me. There we go. Alright, that's absolutely fine. Relax, relax, relax. Alright, we're done here. I'll make a few notes here. Everything is absolutely fine. And we will send you on your way. It's been an absolute pleasure. Lovely to meet you. And I hope you have a lovely rest of your day. Alright. Thanks for coming to see us. Okay, take care then.